shedding a bit more than normal? Is your part looking a little wider than usual, praying for a miracle with your volumizing shampoo? You may be experiencing androgenetic alopecia. It's hereditary hair thinning, and it's the most common form of hair loss for both men and women. It can really sneak up on you. It's usually noticed in your 30s or 40s, though it can begin anytime after puberty. That's one heck of a quinceañera present. Thanks, Mom and Dad. Genetics cue the hair follicles to get narrower, leading to thinner and thinner hair that eventually disappears. For women, it generally happens evenly across the scalp, and it can resemble a Christmas tree pattern. Men get a receding front hairline and a thinning at the crown. While some can take advantage of surgery, most treatments can only delay or minimize the loss. Experiencing a lot of shedding after a major life event? That could be telogen effluvium, a disturbance in the natural hair cycle. Normally, the majority of the hair on our head is in the growth phase, with only a small amount in the rest phase. But a major body stress like severe illness, thyroid disorder, certain medications, and childbirth can kick a ton of hairs into the rest phase. The result is a pronounced shed, 2 to 3 months after the stressful event. Yep, your reward for creating a new human may be losing your hair. Totally unfair. The good news, if you figure out what's triggering the hair loss and put an end to it early, your hair can grow back. You can even enlist a dermatologist to help you pinpoint the problem. On a related note, those that lose their hair from radiation therapy are experiencing anagen effluvium instead of telogen effluvium. That's hair that's lost in the growth phase. If you're experiencing sudden localized patchy hair loss, it could be alopecia areata, an autoimmune disease where inflammatory cells target the hair follicle and prevent hair growth. The silver lining here is that follicles aren't permanently damaged, and that means there's the potential for hair to return, even after many years of hair loss. Hit up your doctor if you're looking for a treatment plan. Lastly, if you're a frequenter of the man bun and it gets pulled too tight, you could be experiencing traction alopecia. Hairstyles like tight ponytails, braids, extensions, cornrows, and dreads can create hair loss from excess tension or weight. This creates short, broken hairs and sometimes even bald spots. Catch the problem early enough and hair grows back. Ignore it and get used to that new buzz cut. The important thing is don't procrastinate. Getting treatment early can mean the difference between keeping your hair or losing it. And don't let anyone minimize your concerns. If your doctor isn't taking you seriously, don't be afraid to switch or see a dermatologist that specializes in hair loss. There are a lot of treatment options available once the cause of your hair loss is identified. I'll even be looking more closely at some of them in future videos. If you have a personal experience with hair loss you want to share, or if you just know something about the topic, I'd love to hear from you in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.